things that I grew up with as a young person was, and this will date me, but I used to listen to the Lone Ranger on the radio. Love the Lone Ranger. Then it came out on TV in black and white. It was a whole new world. I finally got to see what the real Lone Ranger looked like and Tonto. And so that's always been a part of my great love of Western movies. But my, and a number of years ago when we were living in Tyler, this is not in my notes, but the Texas Railroad that runs between Palestine and Rusk, we took our granddaughter on that for a ride, and it was the 75th anniversary of the Lone Ranger episode. And the Lone Ranger stopped the bank robbery and held and captured the bank robbers. And in my office, I have a picture of me and the Lone Ranger. So, but one of the things about the Lone Ranger is he had that companion, Tonto, who was always with him, who supported him, who was there with him every bit of the way, who was looking after him. Today's gospel story is about companions. The two companions that were walking along that 7-mile stretch from Jerusalem to Emmaus, a dusty kind of uninhabited road then, and in that midst appeared this stranger, which they didn't notice him because people came and would go in walking, and he was unrecognizable for whatever reason. And so we know the rest of the story. We know what happened. Because Luke makes very clear what that incident was about. He, like the other gospel writers, are more like John. There's some other meaning in that too. And that's what I want to talk about. I know in my life, as I have grown up over the years, I've had companions along the way. When I was growing up in Houston, I had a couple of companions, two friends from the age of 6 years old. We were pretty inseparable. When we got a little older, we established a very profitable yard cutting business. We made a fortune in cutting yards for $3 a yard. Sometimes you could get $5. And we were rolling in money. And then the evenings, we would play poker. and at least I made a lot of money that way. And it wasn't as, you know, I didn't sweat as much. But they were my companions and my friends. One of them, and they both tried to, I taught them how to hunt and fish. They tried to encourage me to study more. One became a doctor. He was a very successful nephrologist. And the other had a computer company, and then he had a savings and loan. And they both have done well. Still friends, still companions at a distance. And as I've gone through life, I've had other companions along the way that have helped and guided me. When I was younger, I had a companion that I talked to and visited with. And then the times when I became very difficult, I was very difficult for my teachers, and I was very difficult my parents. This was in those wonderful junior high school age years, which some of y'all may remember. Maybe you weren't that good either, but I remember distinctly I was very bad. But I had my companion that I talked to, and I didn't have anybody else to talk to. And during that time, I knew that my companion was there to listen to me. And if I would listen, I would hear that companion. And as I grew older and decided it was time to make a decision about my life and what I was going to do when I grew up, I decided to throw in my lot with my companion. And of course, y'all have guessed that that companion was Jesus Christ. He has been with me all of my life. Sometimes I ignored his presence, and sometimes I listened to him, and sometimes I would take that advice. But he was always there with me, just as Tonto was always with the Lone Ranger. And so, as I've gone through life, I've had that companion, as you have. And during that time of my struggles when I was younger, I had those difficult times when I actually did not believe in God. But I always would come back to that companion who was always there. And in our story, for whatever reason, the two men, the two disciples, the two believers of Jesus did not understand who he was while he was there. And it was not until as he revealed to them the story in the Bible, in the Old Testament, about who he was. But then it was in the breaking of bread that they finally realized who he was. And so those connections helped me understand a little bit about how I get connected with my companion or reconnected. It is reading that scripture to hear the story of Jesus and what he has done for me and for you and for others. You see, in that story of the road to Emmaus, Emmaus is not a town anymore. It disappeared. And those two people, they were really kind of nobodies, only named once. One of the things that I would like to share with you is a quote from Christian Century of about 12 years ago about this story. What makes this story remarkable is how unremarkable it is. I can understand Jesus appearing to the remaining 11 disciples, to the faithful women who followed him, and even to Paul. All very practical appearances in terms of establishing the church and its mission. But Cleopas and his companion are nobodies who have no idea what God might be doing. They could be any one of us. Their road to Emmaus is an ordinary road, the road each of us is on every day. This is what sets this story apart from other accounts of Jesus' Easter appearance. Yes, the story resonates with a sense of the church and its mission and of the tremendous power of the Word and the sacrament to connect us with the presence of God. But its image is of God and a church that walks alongside human confusion, human pain, human loss of faith and hope. Emmaus invites us to expect God to find us. Emmaus challenges us to see that it isn't our unshakable faith and deep spirituality that connects us with the risen Christ, but our smallest gestures of hospitality and friendship. So as we walk along our Emmaus road of ordinary life, remember that you have a companion, and I have a companion. Jesus is there, we have the opportunity in our life, as we go through life on that ordinary road, to be a companion to someone else who may not have a companion, who may not have a friend, to offer hospitality, to offer acceptance, forgiveness, and welcome, so that they may see the risen Christ through you and your presence.